welcome back to this Blazer Cable presentation of the 1985 NBA playoffs. Portland and the Dallas Mavericks tangle in Game 4, a game which could advance the Blazers to the Western Conference semifinals against the Los Angeles Lakers, who, of course, are waiting in the wings, having defeated the Phoenix Suns 3-0. Now, let's talk about one guy we haven't centered on too much, and that's Rolando Blackman. He got 30 points.
Did the Trailblazers bad night. Had a bad night.
Did they do a good job on him in keeping him down to 30?
Well, I think they did a pretty good job on him, but I think both you and I would agree on one thing. The great offensive players, they may get 40, they may get 10 the next night. When they get 10, it's probably not because the defense stopped them, it's because they had an off night. So it seems strange to say that the guy had an off night when he had 30, but he's averaging 38 in the three-game series. Darnell Valentine did a good job. But 30 points tonight, it will not be bad, but I think the big question is going to be Aguirre and Vincent. If Aguirre and Vincent, say, get 24, 25, 26 apiece, that's going to spell trouble. If Aguirre gets 30-some, Blackman gets 30-some, it's going to spell trouble. But again, I think all the pressure is on those few guys. I don't see anyone else stepping forward. There's always a chance of that, but the pressure is distributed on the Trailblazers. You got guys coming off the bench, Michael Thompson, Jim Paxson. They've had tremendous series, and that's not even mentioning the guys that have been starting, and they've played very well as also.
Well, Trailblazers have had the advantage with the starters. The bench has come in to pick them up as well, so they certainly feel good about their position. Now, do you think that we'll see a situation where Mata will be resting anybody as he did in Game 3 with about 12 minutes to go, no Aguirre, no Blackman. They wait until about the five-minute mark before they get in the ballgame.
Well, let's look at it this way. Perkins, Blackman and Aguirre are all averaging over 40 minutes a game. Now, there's only 48 minutes a game. Now, granted, there's been some overtime games, but no, they're not going to get rested. If they don't win tonight, they're going to have all summer to rest. So you know that they'll be out there for big minutes. He will only take them out just to give them enough of a breather to get back in the game.
Well, our owner is here, Larry Weinberg, and he is probably dressed in his red, and along with his wife, they hope that they can close it out and get back down to Los Angeles. They feel that perhaps there's some magic with this team. Would you sense that this team has something special going for it coming into this ballgame?
Well, I haven't said it for a long, long time, but I would tend to agree with that, Steve. You hate to go out on a limb and maybe put pressure in having all the fans and everyone around the country expecting a win, but I think this team could turn into something special. They win here tonight. I think they're going to give the Lakers a run for their money, and who knows what could happen. They talked about a win tonight with Perfella City. Western Conference semifinals. Will win tonight could propel you to the World Championship. So you have to win one of these next two games to do
well,
that.
You've never been timid about making predictions before, so this would be nothing new for you to go out on the wing. The Trailblazers, of course, want to keep the magic going against the Dallas Mavericks, and if Mavericks have their backs against the wall, it's going to be a very difficult contest for them. We'll see if they're up to the task. We'll be back with tonight's ball game right after this.
This program on Comcast SportsNet is brought to you by Sports Radio 95.5 The Game, home of the Blazers, Ducks, Seahawks, and Timbers.
How's it going with the website?
Going great, Babs. Made it really easy for customers to manage their car insurance policy.
Online. Well, you know, that's why we have 24/7 support, so customers can call us anytime.
Does not compute. Error.
Beep. Beep. Beep.
Malfunction, Babs.
Very funny.
Error. Bearing down.
We're not really robots.
I thought we were.
Want a great deal on car insurance? Go to eSurance.
With months of job losses, with family incomes down, and the cost of gas, groceries, and healthcare rising, America's credit card debt is now at an all-time high.
If you're currently one of the millions of Americans who's falling behind on payments, debt settlement programs provide options during these most difficult times. This includes the ability to help settle up to 40% or more of your debt.
These consumers took advantage of debt settlement. And just look at the results. Lyons, New York, reduced debt by $24,000. Inglewood, California, reduced debt by $78,000. Call now for free information on all of your options. Options that could reduce your debt by as much as 40% and lower your payment to as little as $167 per month.
Debt settlement representatives are standing by to take your call and help you get your life back on track. This includes the ability to help settle the debt you owe by 40% or more, and the ability to lower your overall payment to only $167 a month. Make that call now.
Tune in next Saturday for Northwest Log Country as we're joined in studio by Scott Weedman of Three Rivers Marine and Chris Schaefer of Posse Bay, and only right here on Northwest Log Country on Comcast Sportsnet. Game on.
That's me, L508585844P. But I'm not just a number. I have a purpose, a higher purpose.
Have some respect!
Not good. No, man. Hello? No. Finally, the buck stops here.
McDonald's meaty, melty McDouble with 100% beef and cheese. And the juicy McChicken. Just some of the irresistible choices on the dollar menu. Only at McDonald's.
The Dallas Mavericks make a change in their starting lineup. We'll give that to you again. Dale Ellis and Aguirre will start at the forward positions. No Jay Vincent, so they're looking for Vincent to give them that punch. Sam Perkins in the middle, Rolando Blackman, and Brad Davis. How about the matchup for Portland?
Well, the matchup for Portland, Carr and Aguirre, that's not a surprise. And the Ellis Vandeweghe, of course, you know what's going to happen there. Same type of defense that's been happening the first few games. But the point that we should make is that Mata is looking to take some of that pressure off we talked about, relying on Vincent, Aguirre, and Blackman. So he's going to try to get another score, another guy involved in the box score, and that's Dale Ellis. So if he can have four guys that he can count on, well, then he's going to accomplish what he's intended to do by shaking up the lineup here at the start of game number four.
Sam Bowie controls the tap, and the Trailblazers will have the initial possession. Lob inside to Drexler. He can't control it. It comes out of his hands, but Ellis is on the inline. So Portland gets it back with 11 seconds on the shot clock.
And Ellis is guarding Kenny Carr.
Vandeweghe. It won't stay. Carr keeps it alive. Carr against Perkins.
Perkins at first a little tentative going after that loose ball. Kenny Carr out hustling. Now he's tentative here. He reaches in, which is not a wise decision by Sam Perkins.
So it's a shaky start for the Mavericks, and the Trailblazers are now in their third possession. No score in the ball game. Butler works inside to Carr. Blackman rebounds for the Mavericks and attacks the basket right away. Does not stay. Carr rebound. Blackman is down. Valentine. Brad Davis. So we know that Blackman is really hurt because he had a chance for a free one. They're going to take a 20-second timeout to check the damage on Blackman.
Well, Rolando Blackman going against Sam Bowie, trying to get that little finger roll over the top. We're going to have the opportunity to take another look at it. Here comes Blackman. Let's see where he comes down. Up the hip. The hip of Sam Bowie, the left hip, catches Blackman in the midsection. And it looks like it'll probably just be the wind knocked out of him. He's taking a few deep breaths. Looks like he'll stay in the game. Okay, another look here as Blackman penetrates, as he goes up. Now, there's the contact by Bowie, and there was a lot of it, too.
So if you're a Dallas Mavericks fan and if you're Dick Motta, you say, my man not only took a good shot, but we should have been shooting some free throws. The Mavericks will have possession of the basketball. The ball game is tied at zero. Perkins at the top.
Okay, the double team immediately down on Aguirre. Sam Bowie leaving Perkins. That time it didn't work, but they'll try it a few more times, I'm sure.
Ellis against Bowie. His jumper is short, and Bowie will get the foul as he comes over the shoulders of Ellis. So Sam Bowie picks up an early foul. It's the first personal against Bowie, first team against Portland.
Now Ellis doing a good job here trying to get over in front of Bowie, causing the contact, but Bowie trying to go around, leaning over the top, call for the personal foul. We see this play a lot.
Perkins was open. Tough pass from Aguirre. 5 seconds on the shot clock.
Good play by Kenny Carr. Held his position. Brad Davis, realizing the shot clock was running down, had to find someone to get it off to. Kenny Carr not moving. Easy call for the official. First personal on Brad Davis.
So we're almost down to the 10-minute mark, and Portland is still looking for their first score. They're down 2-0. Jumper does not stay for Sam Bowie. Long rebound corralled by Dallas Mavericks' Mark Aguirre.
Sam Bowie's thinking about that shot. He made that throughout the last third of the season, but he's thinking about it now. The Mavericks are daring him to take it.
They're attacking Bowie with Perkins. He misses off the window. Drexler draws a foul against Perkins.
Great job by Clyde Drexler, realizing that the Dallas Maverick defense wasn't picking him up at all. Wasn't turning around trying to stop him. He just takes it all the way to the glass. The second personal foul on Sam Perkins. Now, you mentioned, Steve, that Perkins was trying to work against Sam Bowie, but it's always strange when that, I'm sure, is the coach's philosophy, Mata's, that is, and then the guy turns around and shoots a fadeaway jump shot.
Drexler gets both of the free throws and gets Portland's first score at 9:37. The ball game is tied at 2. Mavericks come around to Blackman. And Blackman strikes for his first jump shot outside. And the Mavericks go on top 2.
For the series, he's shooting 57%. Not bad.
Valentine tries to push it inside to Bowie. Ellis comes over, makes the steal. Aguirre against Valentine.
Traveled
as Bowie steps in the lane.
And that's what we call the intimidation factor, a situation where usually a guy would take it to the basket. Sam Bowie there waiting for Aguirre. Aguirre thinking about how he's going to get the shot off, moving those feet too many steps.
Hey, look, back inside to Bowie.
Oh. So far, Blazers not able to take advantage of that mismatch. Ellis against Bowie.
Both teams have 2 turnovers, and the Dallas Mavericks have a 2-point advantage. 4-2. Perkins goes on his own. This time he attacks the basket, misses that opportunity. Bowie rebounds. Comes Valentine.
Oh, no. That is not a good call. Darnell Valentine gets down the floor very quickly, and Brad David, he's still moving. He's moving over in front of Darnell.
Valentine with the advantage put the pressure on. Brad Davis was not still, but drew the foul with the eye.
Okay, now, that last angle was the exact angle the official had, and from that angle, it did look like a charge, but not from the other one.
Davis on the drive. Clyde Drexler picks up the personal foul. I was surprised we didn't get a chorus of boos as we watched Davis on the drive.
Well, Clyde reaching in, picks up the personal foul. Let's talk a little bit about that mismatch, though, Steve, with Gale Ellis guarding Sam Bowie. Now, mismatch is usually referring to size difference. Gale Ellis is 6'7", 203 pounds. Sam Bowie is 7'1", 235, and that's definitely a mismatch.
We will watch to see if the Trailblazers are able to take advantage of it. They find themselves down 4 in a slow-paced first period. Drexler trying to make something happen. Valentine open.
It's always interesting to see how guys guard other people. Brad Davis doesn't come out on Darnell Valentine, doesn't even attempt to, and Valentine's been hitting that shot, but he misses that one when he's wide open.
Quick turnaround for Aguirre. Jack Ramsey wants to have a timeout. So Portland has a very slow start and find themselves down 8-2, and we have a break in the action at 7:53.
Hey, Duck fans, want to win the ultimate VIP experience? Carl's Jr., a longtime supporter of Ducks Athletics, is giving fans two chances to win the ultimate Oregon Ducks experience. The winners of the grand prize receive two game tickets and pregame sideline passes, plus hotel accommodations, Ducks gear, and more. All compliments of Carl's Jr. First, second, and third place prizes include Carl's Jr. gift cards and signed Ducks gear. Log on to GoDucks.com now for your chance to win.
A story of brotherly love, of beer. 1978, home brewing is legalized. 1983, tired of working for the man, the Widmer brothers quit their jobs and cobbled together a brewery. Today, every batch of Widmer remains true to their goal, to brew beer people love as much as they do. Widmer Hefeweizen, the cloudy beer served with a lemon.
With months of job losses, with family incomes down, and the cost of gas, groceries, and healthcare rising, America's credit card debt is now at an all-time high.
If you're currently one of the millions of Americans who's falling behind on payments, debt settlement programs provide options during these most difficult times. This includes the ability to help settle up to 40% or more of your debt.
These consumers took advantage of debt settlement, and just look at the results. Lyons, New York, reduced debt by $24,000. Inglewood, California, reduced debt by $78,000. Call now for free information on all of your options. Options that could reduce your debt by as much as 40% and lower your payment to as little as $167 per month.
Debt settlement representatives are standing by to take your call and help you get your life back on track. This includes the ability to help settle the debt you owe by 40% or more, and the ability to lower your overall payment to only $167 a month. Make that call now.
Safe. Secure. Protected. Drivers work hard to secure their possessions, but what about their passengers? In a crash, unbuckled passengers are usually thrown from the truck and seriously injured. Or worse. Protect what's really important. Ride inside the cab and buckle up. It's the way to go.
For even more Northwest sports coverage, tune in to Talkin' Ball on Comcast SportsNet. Featuring Ian Furness, Dwight James, and a special guest for every show. Past Blazers, former NBA and college stars. You just never know who might show up. Catch Talkin' Ball, Thursdays at 7 p.m. all summer long on Comcast SportsNet. Game on.
So the Trailblazers are still looking for their first field goal. They seem confused in this particular set as they look for Vandeweghe. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Perkins rebound. So Portland definitely confused in their offensive intentions here early in the ball game. Dallas knows what they want to do. They come back to Aguirre.
And when he's shooting that way, his first two shots, when he doesn't touch anything but the bottom of the net, that tells you one thing, he's got a lot of room for error.
Right inside, the Trailblazers again have some confusion. They come back to Vandeweghe. That one stays. That's the first field goal for Portland, and Vandeweghe's first two. Portland down 6-10-4. Blackman. Going to get Dale Ellis for the personal foul and the rebound situation. Loose ball against Ellis. First against him. Third against the Dallas Mavericks. Trailblazers almost went 5 minutes without scoring.
Almost 5 minutes. And I tell you what that does right away. That takes a lot of the initial pressure off the Mavericks, if there was any there. I mean, these players have played a lot of basketball games as Aguirre picks up his first personal foul. I've always thought that the media and the fans, if you haven't been a basketball player and you haven't played in the NBA, don't realize that these guys have played a bunch of games. The guys that choked and couldn't handle pressure, they've dropped out a long time ago. So these guys can handle it, but it puts the pressure.
Near turnover. Vandeweghe finally chases it down, but the Trailblazers do not look smooth offensively. Valentine misses. Perkins with the rebound.
Now five. Mata wants five. If it's the same play, it's going to end up being a triangle over here for Mark Aguirre as Brad Davis goes down. Now here comes Aguirre. Oh, Ellis is open. Ooh, it's two.
So Ellis strikes from the top. He has his first two other night. Portland down eight, 12-4. Carr misses from close. Perkins with another rebound. So Sam Perkins is doing all of the board work for Dallas. Davis is open at the head of the key. That won't stay. Ellis tries to keep it alive. Three on three. Drexler.
Oh. Quick play by Clyde Drexler. And I tell you, Dick Mata, if you see him in the back of your screen after this, the foul by Rolando Blackman, but Mata, he goes off. He realizes that his team has done a good job half court. He doesn't want any big plays. He can't stop them. There's going to be somebody make a big play. Clyde just made one.
So Mata is saying you've missed two balls.
Well, it will not be the call that wins or loses it for the Mavericks or for the Trailblazers, but this point in the game, that was a nice three to have.
Blackman. Ellis tries to keep it alive and does. Louis knocks it away. We have a whistle against Michael Thompson.
Well, Michael Thompson is picking up the foul. I tell you, Dale Ellis was in there scrambling all over everybody's back to knock this ball loose. He gets it loose, and wisely, Blackman gets it up as quick as he can.
The similarity in these ball games is quite eerie when you think about it, because in game number two, the Trailblazers started off shooting the ball very poorly. Dallas got command and were ahead by as many as 10 or 11 in the period, and the Trailblazers had to fight back. They have now in the ball game Coulter and Michael Thompson, along with Drexler, Bowie, and Vandeweghe.
Well, Steve, you've talked about the tempo, and there's no question about it. A seven-point lead, if a team gets it going, gets a fast break out and running, it's nothing. It's nothing at all. Now, the shot clock, they're going to have to get it up. Oh, that's hard. Easy call. Coulter, though, going in, realizing he had to do something. He didn't have time to pass it back out. If you were going to look at hindsight, he might have pulled up with a jump shot. But the shot clock is going down, and that's an easy call. He makes a charge. But, Steve, as you mentioned, the tempo is so important, because if the Blazers can get out running, they can erase that seven-point deficit very quick. But if they're in a half-court game all night, Blazers lose. But that's not going to happen. Something will get the game picked up. Someone will get the rebounds and the fast break going.
Wallace Bryant in the ball game with the Dallas Mavericks. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Mark Aguirre.
And he's got it going. He had that room for error. He hit the rim that time.
Aguirre has six, and the Dallas Mavericks lead by nine, 16-7. Lob to Drexler.
And that was set up perfectly. Wallace Bryant been on a little semi-vacation, not by his choice, the last couple of games, but he can't get over there in time to stop that perfect pass from Coulter to Drexler.
16-9. We're down to 4-11. The Mavericks come back to Aguirre. Draws a foul against Thompson. That will be Michael's second.
You're looking at a situation here with Michael Thompson that happens. Once a guy hits a few outside jump shots, what do? You got to get up there and stop him from shooting the outside shot. And as a result, they get that step, go to the hoop, Aguirre leaning in, but still Michael Thompson moving. The defensive player will never get that call.
Aguirre shot 73% for the season, shooting 81 in the playoffs. Gets both of the free throws. The lead for the Mavericks again is 9, 18-9. Drexler is the offensive story for Portland. He has 7 of the 9 points. They lob to Brewer.
Okay, a good call.
The Mavericks are overplaying Dale Ellis. That's the only way he can stop Sam Bowie, but he's way overplaying. You can see he's so far out on top, he doesn't even have a chance. He's not even in the picture.
Aguirre from the outside. The rebound is long. Thompson corrals it. Vandeweghe.
The miss and the fast break. In my book, that's a fast break anytime you get that open jump shot.
The crowd comes alive as Portland creeps to within five, 18-13.
We're just in the first quarter. This could be the end of a game type atmosphere right now, but it's the first quarter.
Benson will make his first appearance at 3:17 in the first period. Dale Ellis, no, Mark Aguirre will go down.
Okay, now the real key for the Mavericks tonight is going to take place in the next few minutes. Can Jay Vincent get his jump shot to go in?
Blackman. Ellis, strong rebound.
Ooh,
and follow.
How big is that guy?
6'7", 203. Vandeweghe from the corner.
Oh, that's quick. And it's accurate.
Vandeweghe has six.
Tonight, they're looking for Vincent.
Blackman's going to be short. Ellis keeps it alive. Stolen by Steve Coulter. Three on one. Lobbed out of bounds, but Clyde Drexler is there to catch it.
Well, maybe Steve Coulter was just lobbing that enough in front of him that Clyde had to give it back to him.
So we got a break in the action at 2:25. The Dallas Mavericks 20, the Trailblazers 17. We'll be back with more first period action right after this.
Sandwich lady, 2 o'clock.
Oh.
Hey.
5:50.
Actually, we're all good today, sandwich lady. We love your chicken sandwiches, but Taco Bell's got chicken flatbread sandwiches for under $1. So.
5:50.
No, 5:50. Under $1. You don't scare me.
It's under $1, and not everyone's happy about it. The new chicken flatbread sandwich. Warm flatbread, flame-grilled chicken, and melty cheese. Only at Taco Bell. Why pay more?
Story of brotherly love, of beer. 1984, brothers Kurt and Rob Widmer turn a homebrewing hobby into a vocation. 1986, the Widmer brothers pioneer the American Hefeweizen. To complement its natural citrus notes, they serve it with a lemon, and a legend is born. Today, it remains the definitive American wheat beer. Widmer Hefeweizen, the cloudy beer served with a lemon.
James, outside, James, is it clear? James, to the 30, for Michael James, to the 10, 5, touchdown, Oregon lead.
On January 12th, a massive earthquake ravaged Haiti's capital, taking the lives of hundreds of thousands of people and leaving millions more without water, food, and shelter.
During our time in public service, we've witnessed firsthand the extraordinary generosity of the American people in the face of tragedy here at home and around the world.
But there's still so much to do. So please join the Clinton Bush Haiti Fund and other organizations as we answer the call to help Haiti build back better.
Thank you.
Hey, Duck football fans. On Monday nights, check out a new weekly show on Comcast Sportsnet. Oregon Football with Chip Kelly, featuring game recaps, insider info, and the most in-depth Oregon football coverage around. Oregon Football with Chip Kelly, Mondays at 8 p.m. on Comcast Sportsnet.
This football season, rent a tailgate party bus from Portland Limousine. 16 or 32 passenger for your group or company, and ride to the Ducks, Beavers, or Seahawks in style. Party on at tailgatepartybus.com.
No matter what kind of camper you are, Next Adventure has the camping gear you need and low prices every day. The backpacker has options when it comes to comfort at Next Adventure. Lightweight tents, sleeping bags, and sleeping pads. Plus, portable chairs, camp stoves, food, and more. The car camper has the ultimate in luxury with products from Next Adventure. The turbo tent, sleeping cots, all kinds of stoves, and everything you need for a plush campsite. Choose your level of comfort at Next Adventure. That's Deacon Bryant's Next Adventure. Two local guys and crew who understand adventure.
This football season, rent a tailgate party bus from Portland Limousine. 16 or 32 passenger for your group or company, and ride to the Ducks, Beavers, or Seahawks in style. Party on at tailgatepartybus.com.
So after being down by as many as nine, the Trailblazers have fought their way back to within three. Paxson enters the ball game at 2:25. The Mavericks have 18 seconds on the shot clock. Blackman dances around Paxson, but gets help from Vandeweghe. Portland turns it over. Coulter to Paxson. Thompson running stuff shot brings Portland within one. Vincent still has a tough time from the field.
That should go against Vincent as he was reaching in, pulling down. And that's exactly what's going to happen. And right now, the inability for Rolando Blackman to get his shot going again. There isn't anybody to answer. There isn't anybody to come in there and do something to help him out. And the Blazers, in playing the great defense on Blackman, maybe getting away with a little tickle in the elbow once or twice, but getting out on the fast break, have things going their way.
Vandeweghe has yet to miss a free throw in this playoff series. He's now 11 of 11. The Trailblazers have their first lead of the night, 21-20. So once again, they have clawed their way back into a ballgame after a very poor start. Down to 1:39. Mavericks look inside to Vincent with 10 seconds on the shot clock. That tough shot, lean away from Thompson, goes in. And Vincent has his first two, and Mavericks yo-yo back on top, 22-21.
Oh, nice pass. Ellis again. You can't fall if you're playing a freshman defense, but he hasn't been able to react after the Blazers picked him up on the back door. He can't get back quick enough, and that was a perfect pass. Good catch by Vandeweghe. 2 points, chance to make it three.
In that situation, defensively, a lot of the blame also has to go to the guy pressuring the passer. Sam Bowie had a lot of time to pick up Kiki Vandeweghe, who now has 11 points, and the Trailblazers lead by two, 24-22.
Uh-oh. Bowie was chasing Jerry Carper. He immediately shows his emotion that he wasn't involved in that play. Sam has a habit of showing those emotions when he doesn't foul. And he also has a habit of doing it once in a while when he does foul. He can go either way on that. I think he had a legitimate argument there. That was a little bit more emotion than he usually shows.
Carr will replace Bowie, who leaves the ball game with two personal fouls. Now, whenever Dallas has been able to get some inside attack going, it's been with Bowie on the bench.
That's true, and I'm sure they'll try to go inside. Now, the question is, though, will it? Not necessarily in the center. I don't think they'll go to Wallace Bryant, but as you say, Steve, they'll try to get Vincent or Aguirre down low now.
Trailblazers have outscored the Dallas Mavericks 15-6 to get the ball game in a tied situation at 24. Carr muscles his way inside. Vincent reaches in
and calls for the foul. Kenny Carr, he just kept faking until he had a chance to get to the middle. Wallace Bryant, it could have been on either one of them as both of them reach in.
So Carr, who was the hero in game number three when he ran off 10 straight points and the Trailblazers took a three-point advantage, stepped to the line for the first time tonight. Misses long. The ball bounces long. Portland outfights the Dallas Mavericks for the loose ball. So 44 seconds to go. The Trailblazers have a chance to add two more. Thompson. Blackman comes back for the rebound. Harper and Blackman in the backcourt. Wallace Bryant, who's out high, Mark McGwire now in the ballgame, and they pick up a foul against Paxson.
Well, Jim, after he fights over the screen, looked like he might be trying to come around the back of Blackman to make the steal. Once he was beat, he thought he better reach back and try to do something, but all he had was the left arm of Blackman.
Blackman has had a sensational series in every category, shooting 95% from the line on 23 of 24. Drexler replaces Steve Coulter, so the backcourt combination will be Paxson and Drexler. Blackman had a slow start in game number two. Came back after the intermission and went crazy. So it will not be the kind of situation where he will not get the opportunity. He now has six. Drexler goes for a solo and misses. Paxson for three. Vandeweghe muscles inside, so Drexler comes up with the ball. And the first period is over. The Dallas Mavericks 26, the Portland Trailblazers 25. And when you go back, there is a score at the end of game two. It's a one-point ball game again.
Get real-time answers from real, live salespeople. Check prices, get your questions answered, or book a test drive. Online, in real time, right now. Live answers, live price, live person. BeavertonToyota.com.
With months of job losses, with family incomes down and the cost of gas, groceries, and healthcare rising, America's credit card debt is now at an all-time high.
If you're currently one of the millions of Americans who's falling behind on payments, debt settlement programs provide options during these most difficult times. This includes the ability to help settle up to 40% or more of your debt.
These consumers took advantage of debt settlement, and just look at the results. Lyons, New York, reduced debt by $24,000. Inglewood, California, reduced debt by $78,000. Call now for free information on all of your options. Options that could reduce your debt by as much as 40% and lower your payment to as little as $167 per month.
Debt settlement representatives are standing by to take your call and help you get your life back on track. This includes the ability to help settle the debt you owe by 40% or more, and the ability to lower your overall payment to only $167 a month. Make that call now.
EA Sports. It's in the game. Madden NFL 11 from EA Sports is here. Now through an exclusive partnership between EA Sports and Sports Illustrated, you can get Madden NFL 11, the full game, the same one sold in stores, included when you subscribe to Sports Illustrated. This amazing deal is only available while supplies last. Call or go online to SITVOffer.com now. Order 28 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $59.95, and you'll get Madden NFL 11 included with your paid subscription. As a bonus, you'll get the making of Madden NFL DVD. EA Sports takes you behind the scenes of the number one sports video game of all time. This exclusive package is available only with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. These items at retail would cost almost $200, but through this amazing offer, just $59.95 gets you all of this. A subscription to Sports Illustrated, EA Sports Madden NFL 11, the making of Madden NFL DVD, all in a limited time offer. Don't miss out on this unbelievable value. Go online, SITVOffer.com, or call now.
Relive the drama. Relive the excitement. Relive the intensity. Relive the moment.
Looking, throwing, caught!
Catch an encore presentation of the Ducks football game against Tennessee, Saturday at 11 and Sunday at 6:30 on Comcast SportsNet.
Get real-time answers from real, live salespeople. Check prices, get your questions answered, or book a test drive. Online, in real time, right now. Live answers, live price, live person. BeavertonToyota.com.
The Mavericks will start the second half, the second period with Harper and Davis in the backcourt, Vincent Aguirre and Wallace Bryant up front. Brad Davis finally got his shooting on track. The Trailblazers led game number one by one, 24-23 at the end of one. The Mavericks lead in game four, 26-25. They double on Aguirre. Brad Davis leads for Derek Harper.
Yeah, he grabbed his forehead on that one, but you can't say too much. The team was scrambling, double teaming. You're not going to stop them every time when you're doing that.
They back off Drexler. And he accepts the challenge, and he has his ninth point. And it's a one-point lead for Dallas, 28-27. McGuire hops and gets away with it and has
just 10.
Wasn't a big one. A small hop.
30-27. They look to Paxson. He pulls the trigger.
As his first two, looked like he wasn't going to shoot.
No, he pops it. Sometimes a shooter, when he gets out of that rhythm and stops, it's hard to get it back up there and through, but that shot didn't have any trouble going in. And by Drexler, guarding Wallace Bryant.
Quick whistle.
Well, that's because Kenny Carr putting a little bit too much muscle on Jay Vincent, but that's okay. I mean, it's going to be a three-point play for the Mavericks, but you still want to do as much as you can and get away with, and that forearm in the back of Vincent was a little bit too much, and so now Kenny Carr realizes what he can do and what he can't.
Again, we focus on the eyes of Jay Vincent. He blinks and gets the bounce. The Mavericks get the three-point play and lead by 4-33-29.
He must be blinking on his jumper.
Perkins back in the ball game. Portland gets a roll on Michael Thompson over Derek Harper. Thompson has 4. 2-point lead for Dallas, 33-31. Drexler pokes that one away. McGuire trying to go down the lane, loses control, turnover Dallas. We move under 10 minutes to play, and Portland with this possession can bring the ball game back to another tie. McGuire backs off Drexler. Again, he takes the free shot and nails it. He has 11. The ball game is tied at 33. Another three-point play coming up as McGuire cashes in, this time against Thompson. That will be Thompson's third.
Okay, that hurt. Thompson had a great series. Now watch the hop. Watch this. Right, ball down. That is a hop. That's what we call a hop. But what is it, Steve, when it's part of a man's game, when he does it all the time, you usually don't get called for it.
So McGuire now will step to the line and try to put Dallas up by 3. He has 13.
Should that have been trapped?
Well, he dribbled the ball, so I think that may have gotten him out of that particular situation.
If you're a Blazer fan, it was traveling all the way. Paxson will get the hand check against Derek Harper. First personal against Harper, first team. The crowd now says, we were shooting. Coulter fakes the three. Audie Norris has replaced Michael Thompson. Barr hops inside, so it all evens out.
Vincent wanting an elbow on Carr. There was not any there. His elbow was there, but only going up for the shot. Not an offensive foul. Wasn't even close.
Carr's dunk over the top makes it a one-point advantage for Dallas. McGuire misses long. Norris gets the rebound. Knocked away.
Okay, let's look at the replay here.
A foul away from the ball on Mark McGuire on the hold.
And that was a big call because Jay Vincent had knocked that ball away from Kenny Carr, and the Mavericks were going the other direction. Good idea here, Steve.
Porter looks inside for a triangle with Norris. The ball is knocked away by Derek Harper. Good pass inside from Drexler to Coulter, and Portland's on top by 1.
Okay, the good idea I was going to talk about is if you're trying to get the ball down, the Audie Norris is trying to pick up the third personal with Sam Perkins.
They come inside to Perkins. Doesn't get the shot over. Drexler. Carr rebounds. Porter with a one-point advantage.
Carr, when he comes down the court, is sort of the fifth guy on the fast break and sort of eases into that spot in his rhythm. He hits a very high percentage.
So Portland has a three-point advantage, 39-36. They've scored six straight. Perkins on the drive. Easy call to make as somebody gets a long arm of Perkins.
Well, Perkins, he doesn't have his steps down. As he goes in here, he gets his feet a little tangled up with Steve Colfer. Not a lot of contact, but Colfer picks up the foul.
So Dick Mata comes back bigger. He takes Gabe Vincent out of the ballgame, brings Wallace Bryan in, so that means Perkins will definitely be in the low post area.
This Perkins-Wallace Bryant combination is definitely a result of the rebounding edge the Trailblazers are holding over the Mavericks in the first three games.
The Mavericks have now made 39 straight free throws. So as a team, they're shooting the ball extremely well from the line, just haven't been able to get there a lot. Portland leads by one, 39-38.
And Jack's up and throwing his hands up saying it's a busted play.
Wallace Bryant pulled down the miss by Drexler. McGuire body to the floor and Derek Harper rolls inside for the follow.
Now we're going to watch the play of Derek Harper, but if we can see, watch the right side of your screen if you can. He's already in. Throwing Aguirre out of the way. We're going to have another look at it. First, a play by Derek Harper. Now, we got another camera on Audie Norris and Mark Aguirre. You don't think there's some contact there? Watch. Aguirre going to come back in. Great job by Blazer Broadcasting. George Wash, our director, is picking up all those different angles.
Dallas is now 15 of 15 from the line, and they hold a two-point advantage, 41-39, as the Trailblazers come back to their spread attack. Coulter for three. And over the top. So we've got a break in the action. It's 6:54. The Mavericks 41, the Trailblazers 39. We'll be back with more second period action right after this.
A story of brotherly love, of beer. 1978, home brewing is legalized. 1983, tired of working for the man, the Widmer brothers quit their jobs and cobble together a brewery. Today, every batch of Widmer remains true to their goal, to brew beer people love as much as they do. Widmer Hefeweizen, the cloudy beer served with a lemon.
Catch Emerald Downs live every Saturday on Comcast Sportsnet. Covering all the odds, all the interviews, and all the horses. Emerald Downs Live. Sunday on Comcast Sportsnet.
If you are a fan of courage, if you admire determination, if you are impressed by grace under pressure, and can't help but share in the joy of victory, then you are already a fan of Special Olympics. Make it official. Volunteer, coach, or compete. And be a fan of dignity, acceptance, and the human race. Special Olympics. Be a fan.
Take my hand and start a brand new day. And together as one will...
Underneath everything we are, underneath everything we do, we are all people. Connected, interdependent, united. And when we reach out a hand to one, we can influence the condition of all. That's what it means to live united.
With months of job losses, with family incomes down and the cost of gas, groceries, and healthcare rising, America's credit card debt is now at an all-time high.
If you're currently one of the millions of Americans who's falling behind on payments, debt settlement programs provide options during these most difficult times. This includes the ability to help settle up to 40% or more of your debt.
These consumers took advantage of debt settlement, and just look at the results. Lyons, New York, reduced debt by $24,000. Inglewood, California, reduced debt by $78,000. Call now for free information on all of your options. Options that could reduce your debt by as much as 40% and lower your payment to as little as $167 per month.
Debt settlement representatives are standing by to take your call and help you get your life back on track. This includes the ability to help settle the debt you owe by 40% or more, and the ability to lower your overall payment to only $167 a month. Make that call now.
So the Trailblazers seesaw back and forth with the Dallas Mavericks. The Mavericks hold a two-point advantage, 41-39.
Well, Kenny Carr, using his strength in there to get position for the rebound, knocked away by Harper, but then Kenny Carr hustling back out there to pick up the basketball. And Kenny, Clyde Drexler, now watch him look along the baseline, the double team, and he's just going to find Steve Coulter there all by himself. And this is the kind you think, oh, I can't miss this, but it hasn't happened before. Not this time, but Steve Coulter puts it in for two more for the Blazers.
Coulter has four, but leaves the ball game. Valentine will replace him. He will join Paxson in the backcourt. Drexler will move up front with Carr and Sam Bowie. Dallas counters with Davis and Harper, Sam Perkins and Mark Aguirre. Aguirre gets all kinds of people around him. The ball comes along to Perkins. Ryan keeps it alive. Aguirre back up for the follow. Aguirre has 15.
That was a triple team that time on Aguirre. Everybody was after him.
If Portland has had a problem today, it's been getting into whatever offensive set they want. As Paxson comes back from the outside, he has four.
Jay Paxson's been a force off the bench. He's averaged 25 minutes a game the first three games and has scored 16 on the average. That's a lot of points in only 25 minutes on an average.
They come back to Aguirre down low against Drexler. They triple, but it's too late.
He can get him up quick, but the thing he's doing, he's looking for Perkins. That's the guy that's going to be open.
Four-point advantage for Dallas as Carr works. The ball is knocked away. The action man is Drexler. He comes off the window real hard. Harper rebound.
A hard shot. Both ways. Hard to make the move.
Drexler comes around with the steal and the save. It's 2-on-1. Valentine to Paxson.
Oh, and Paxson has been consistent.
So Paxson has six all in the period.
Given by Drexler. Credit for that.
Big defensive play by Drexler to get that break started. Quick turnaround by Aguirre. This one will not stay off the window. Bowie rebound.
Okay, now what they're doing, and they're giving up this chances for offensive rebounds to bring Rawls Bryant real high.
Paxson with the tough slide that comes off the glass. So he's hit his last three in a row to bring the ball game to another tie at 45.
But what Mavericks are doing, they're bringing Bryant out, trying to force the defense away from Mark Aguirre. But if Aguirre misses, there isn't any chance. And they're going to get Wallace Bryant. He's been throwing that hip out there every time a guy runs off of the pick. But this time he gets caught.
Harper out of the ball game for the Mavericks. Rolando Blackman in, Kenny Carr out, Kiki Vandeweghe in, so Portland comes back with the small lineup. Vandeweghe back in against Perkins. 8 seconds on the clock, Valentine out to Paxson. Ryan does a good job of keeping Bowie away. Sam Perkins comes up with the basketball. Perkins for three. Paxson gets the rebound. Portland runs Drexler can't control it about this. Right back to Paxton. Wallace Bryan. Picks up the 18th rebound for the Mavericks, and Dallas gets a wire on the baseline. Long rebound comes off of Vandeweghe.
Is this enough action for you?
Well, I'll tell you. The Dallas Mavericks have had a problem. They're trying to correct it, and the Trailblazers are trying to keep the pressure on by going to the board. One of the guys has done a good job on the board, Michael Thompson. He will come in. Paxton goes out of the ball game. Any reproduction or rebroadcast of tonight's game is strictly prohibited unless authorized by Blazer Broadcasting. Announcers are selected and paid by Pro Basketball Incorporated. Aguirre quickly. So Aguirre, who had a great first half, had 24 against Portland in game number 3, working on the same sort of numbers, has 19, and Dallas leads by 2, 47-45. Thompson looking for the tie.
Well, Perkins tries to knock the ball away low before Thompson gets it up. Didn't work.
Ball game is tied at 47. And the Dallas Mavericks want a timeout. So we have a break in the action at 3:12, and the ball game is tied at 47.
Tomorrow on Comcast SportsNet.
Absolutely. This policy is customized just for you.
Well, this will save you the most money while making sure that you have the auto coverage that you need.
This is good stuff.
Yeah, no problem. I'm a coverage counselor. It's what I do. Well, thank you for being an insurance customer. Great. Bye, Richard. So did you guys get enough to make an online version of a coverage counselor?
Yep. It's code it and load it.
Oh. You're so popular. Like prom queen.
Want a great deal on car insurance? Go to eSurance.
What's my game plan? To use what I was born with. Which is why I don't use steroids. Steroids can destroy the body that I worked so hard to build. Steroids aren't part of my game plan. How about you?
EA Sports. It's in the game. Madden NFL 11 from EA Sports is here. Now through an exclusive partnership between EA Sports and Sports Illustrated, you can get Madden NFL 11, the full game, the same one sold in stores, included when you subscribe to Sports Illustrated. This amazing deal is only available while supplies last. Call or go online at SITVOffer.com now. Order 28 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $59.95, and you'll get Madden NFL 11 included with your paid subscription. As a bonus, you'll get the making of Madden NFL DVD. EA Sports takes you behind the scenes of the number one sports video game of all time. This exclusive package is available only with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. These items at retail would cost almost $200. But through this amazing offer, just $59.95 gets you all of this. A subscription to Sports Illustrated, EA Sports Madden NFL 11, the making of Madden NFL DVD, all in a limited time offer. Don't miss out on this unbelievable value. Go online, SITVOffer.com, or call now.
Tune in next Saturday for Northwest Log Country as we're joined in studio by Scott Weedman of Three Rivers Marine and Chris Schaefer of Posse Bait, only right here on Northwest Log Country on Comcast Sportsnet. Game on.
The year was 1985. High socks, short shorts, big hair. We take you back 25 years to relive one of the most exciting playoff series in Blazers history. Featuring some of your favorite past Blazers and the colorful flair they brought to the game. The year is 1985 and the stage is set. Round one of the Western Conference playoffs between your Portland Trail Blazers and the Dallas Mavericks. Game 4, tonight at 7 on Comcast Sportsnet.
So the Mavericks have it with 16 seconds on the shot clock. Blackman is on the floor. Aguirre's on the floor. Blackman misses. Aguirre saves. Off the glass.
Uh-oh, that's 3, I believe, on Bowie. Bowie gets hit as Aguirre goes up. And I want to tell you, if you could classify a couple of the moves by Aguirre, I think it might be more of street basketball that he is using out there, because he's taking his body And once he has the ball, he's punishing. He's punishing the defensive player by going right through him. And just with enough contact to make the defensive player pay a heavy price. And you wonder why Mark Aguirre can get away with that. Well, this guy, if you'd stand next to him, he would not seem that big. He's only 6'6", but he weighs 230 pounds. So all he has to do is put an arm and a hip on you, and if he goes through you with that, he wants the contact.
Well, there's one thing we know. That body hides weight well because he's been bigger. As we take a look at the time remaining in the first half of play, Aguirre's had several three-point opportunities the hard way, cashed them all. Mavericks have yet to miss a free throw here.
Maybe that'll put the jinx on.
I think it's now 40 in a row. 41. And the Mavericks go up by three, 50 to 47.
Good play here by Jack.
Vandeweghe's free throw, drive will not fall, but he will get to the free throw line.
Well, the foul's going to go against
Wallace Bryant.
And that will not hurt the Mavericks at all. The guy they wanted to get the foul against was Mark Aguirre. The clear out was called for Kiki Vandeweghe, a good smart play.
A nervous Sigmata looks on, knowing that this could be the ball game that starts the summer early for him if they lose. Vandeweghe has 13. The Mavericks lead by one. Inside to Perkins. Right hand.
Ooh, that was pretty. He made a good, strong move. Didn't hesitate at all. And they're going to try to get the ball again to him.
Vandeweghe just inside the three-point line.
How many fouls does Aguirre have now? Two, Steve?
He has two. Aguirre has two, and Vandeweghe has 15. Mavericks lead by one. Quick pass inside to Aguirre. Oh. Almost spun in off of a misdirected shot at the hoop.
Almost. Got a very, very lucky break. As you can watch the pass, it's perfect. But to watch Aguirre as he goes up, Kiki fouls him. And then he just throws it up, and look at that. That was hit in.
As you like to say, we know he has it going. Well, he has it going because he has 23. Norris comes in the ballgame. Michael Thompson with the three personal fouls will sit down. Aguirre now has matched his first half total of ballgame number three with another 24 points. And the Mavericks lead by three, 54-51.
They have to go to well, pretty easy to get to Vandeweghe. They probably try to get him on the other side. They want the ball.
He bumps and misses. Oh, what a... The ball gets tipped out and will go to the Mavericks.
Who had the hand on the ball? They tried to tip it in. Was that Audie Norris?
It looked like Norris tried to throw that one in. They come back to Aguirre. Eight seconds on the shot clock. Blackman doesn't have a thing going so far tonight. Misses Drexler to Sam Perkins. It all evens out. Blackman gone to solo from the side, and Valentine reaches in, and they give Portland the basketball. Valentine comes down and gets his first two. Let's see if Blackman's the type of player who gets a bad call and suddenly wakes up and asks for the basketball.
Yes, and you knew that was going to happen, right?
Got a
bad
call.
No matter what happened. No matter what happened. There had to have been a foot between the defensive man and Rolando Blackman not to have had that call. And I think if we're honest, Steve, you have to say he probably deserved it. Looked like he was fouled pretty good. Now, there's a bump. Not a lot, but there was a bump there. Blackman at the line.
Wow. Blackman has struggled from the field, but has not had that problem at the free throw line. But again, we know that he is a player that can strike for a lot of points in a period and suddenly get hot. That one rolls in. The lead for the Mavericks, with 59 seconds remaining in the half, 56-53. They leave an open court for Valentine. Norris keeps it court for Valentine. Norris keeps it alive. Carr comes back. Aguirre powers inside for the rebound, so Portland had three chances in close and couldn't cash. Brad Davis for three. Perkins rebound. Adi Norris will pick up his second personal foul. Penalty situation is in play for the Dallas Mavericks.
I would like to see those Hollywood stuntmen in that last ruckus underneath. They want to. That would get them in shape for all those stunts.
Paxson will replace Valentine with 30 seconds remaining in the second period. Vincent comes in with the same time remaining for Mark Aguirre. Perkins misses for the Dallas Mavericks, who had made 20 in a row and 45 consecutive going back to previous ballgame.
We got class.
If they lose, they'll blame it on Sam Perkins. One free throw miss. 4-point advantage for the Dallas Mavericks, 57-53. Drexler will trigger Portland's attack to Paxson. Drexler with a hard drive against Blackman for two more. He has 13. So Dallas will hold for the final shot of the half. They come to Perkins for three. He doesn't cash. Brad Davis gets it back up, but it doesn't stay, and the first half is over. The Dallas Mavericks hold a slim two-point advantage, 57-55, in another ball game which has been at the pace which they like. The Trailblazers again doing some strong work on the board to stay close in this ball game after falling down early. And Jack Ramsey again will be looking for something to pick them up.
What's your 2:30 feeling like?
Well, it's like my brain just stops working.
Feel fuzzy, groggy.
I can barely keep my eyes open.
So what do you do?
I used to get another coffee.
Yeah, coffee or soda.
Then another coffee.
But I switched to 5-Hour Energy.
Just one 5-Hour Energy.
The rest of the day, I'm great.
Zero sugar, only 4 calories.
I don't feel jittery. I'm in control. It's me. Just a better, more awake me.
Gotta try 5-Hour Energy.
5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now. No 2:30 feeling later.
A story of brotherly love, of beer. 1984, brothers Kurt and Rob Widmer turn a homebrewing hobby into a vocation. 1986, the Widmer brothers pioneer the American Hefeweizen. To complement its natural citrus notes, they serve it with a lemon, and a legend is born. Today, it remains the definitive American wheat beer. Widmer Hefeweizen, the cloudy beer served with a lemon.
Millions of teens have found a whole new way to get high on drugs that are all over the neighborhood. Legal drugs they can get anytime they want, for free, in almost any home in America. Cough medicines, prescription painkillers. Last year, more teens intentionally abused them than ecstasy, meth, and heroin combined. Learn how to talk to your kids about the drugs they get at home at drugfree.org.
Hey, how's it going?
Do you have a minute?
I want you to meet my auto insurance company.
You
should get to know these guys.
They're really something. One thing you'll learn about Amica customers is that they love their car insurance company, and they love to tell people about it. When I was in my accident, Amica paid the claim like that.
I did a ton of research. There are so many reasons to switch to Amica.
Call Amica now. We'll take the time to ask questions, explain your options, and find the coverage that's right for you. No wonder we've been recognized for our customer satisfaction and financial stability year after year. So call Amica now.
There was a lot of anxiety when I had the accident. Amica took it away.
I was covered just like they said I would be. Amica is a mutual insurance company.
The customers own the company.
That's me.
That's me.
That's me.
Usually you have to pay for the best service. I actually save money.
Call Amica now for your free quote. You could save hundreds when you switch to Amica. So let's recap.
Unbeatable service.
Complete coverage.
Solid company.
And I save money.
You gotta love that. What are you waiting for? Call Amica.
The Mavericks will start with possession of the basketball and will kick off the second half of play. Blackman, Davis in the backcourt, Ellis and Aguirre, and Sam Perkins up front. Mavericks with a two-point advantage. They come right back to the two-man game between Blackman and Aguirre. Blackman still cannot miss it. He took plenty of time with that one. It's from Valentine and the Trailblazers. Vandeweghe ties it at 57. He has 17.
They're really going to start disliking Kiki Vandeweghe in Dallas.
Valentine with the near steal. Brad Davis is open, and he was an effective player in game number three. Vandeweghe comes in with some quick hands and knocks the ball off the foot of Dale Ellis.
Great defensive play by Kiki Vandeweghe. He knocks the ball down, but the Mavericks come back with a good play of their own.
Brad Davis leads for Ellis. So they had a transition hoop and end up with nothing, and will set their offense with the ball game tied at 57.
Well, they're not a fast-breaking team. They showed why.
The problem for the Dallas Mavericks is they are a jump-shooting team, and that can create some problems. Valentine and Vandeweghe play catch, and Portland goes on top with four straight, 59-57. Perkins inside. Valentine will draw the foul.
Darnell Valentine trying to come back and help out, and he needed to help out because Sam Bowie had allowed Sam Perkins to get too close to the hoop. There's the easy call, but Perkins was going up, and Bowie thinking about how many fouls he's got, decides to let him go, and that's because he has three personal fouls.
So Perkins on the night at the free throw line.
A little late.
He's 4 of 5. And has the only miss of the night for them. Broke their string of 45 consecutive with that one miss. Perkins has 9 in the ball game. It's tied again at 59. Push it inside, rolls it off the back of Kenny Carr. Turnover against Portland. They have 7.
Well, Kenny Carr was trying to get turned around, just hadn't quite made the turn so he could see the ball coming from Vandeweghe.
Blackman is against Carr. Davis for 3. They will try until they get it right. This time the stroke is true for Brad Davis. Davis has 5. The Mavericks lead is 3.
Oh, good play.
Excellent pass from Sam Bowie to Kenny Carr, who was clean inside. He takes it over the top. Dick Motta wants to know how his man got down on the floor.
Well, Perkins was guarding Kenny Carr, I believe, and he just puts it. Oh, it's going to go on Sam Bowie. Sam didn't move his feet quick enough to get over there. Contact, Sam goes down, not saying too much, and the reason is he just didn't move when Perkins makes the move, and you really cannot call that any other way.
He tried to draw the charge but could not. They come back quickly to Aguirre, who gets a whistle against Carr. So Portland picks up 2 quick personals. Second against Kenny Carr, now third team with 9:37 for the Mavericks, who shot three throws well in this ball game, would hope that they could get to the penalty. Blackman draws a foul against Drexler.
Light, very upset on that. We're going to have an opportunity with the replay to see whether he was had a right to be upset. You cannot tell from that angle, but I guarantee you that Clyde Drexler was very, very upset.
As strong as he's been that bad tonight so far.
Glad to see he's human.
Blackman gets one of two. He has nine, and the Mavericks' lead is two.
Now, the question is, for Sam Bowie with four fouls, what will they try?
Vandeweghe from long distance. Perkins with a good rebound.
And Sam, he was coming in very strong for that rebound.
Ellis will get the foul against Drexler.
And Clive is reaching in. Now, the thing that happens is you have a couple of marginal calls, and pretty soon everybody thinks they're getting the bump steer when they get to hear the whistle. Now, there's the reach in by Clyde. It looked like a little ball, a little hand, but Jack Ramsey's going to have to make a change, and I would think would be for Sam Bowie.
Two keys, Drexler and Bowie. Bowie on the inside. Drexler just making things happen. Bowie will get his call to the bench at 9:08. Thompson comes in with three personal fouls. Mavericks, I guess we can say, are missing with regularity at the free throw line now. They're down to 50% in their last two tries. Ellis gets this one and makes it a three-point lead for Dallas, 64-61.
And that tempo we've been talking about happens easier when Sam Bowie's in there for the block shot and the four shot.
Drexler cannot do that, and they let him get away with it. He threw a pass to himself.
Well, Rooney is saying that it was kicked. The official, both officials agree, but you would be right, Steve, if no one touched it.
Aguirre gets whistled for the foul against Kenny Carr. Wallace Bryant will check into the ball game. Dale Ellis goes out.
Okay, now watch Aguirre. On the left side of your screen, the Kenny Carr is there to see. Oh, yes, you see that arm go out. Now, Kenny may have been using some Mark Aguirre tricks, but he needs to.
Valentine will not get that one to go off the window. Ramsey wants a goal 10.
And he's not going to get it, but he was hoping that there'd be goal tending against Sam Perkins as Valentine makes a good move against Brad Davis. He goes up. Here comes Perkins over. Let's see. I don't think he touched it. If he did, it looked like he was still on the way up.
Valentine has had an excellent series from the line. He was 10 of 10 coming into tonight's ball game. Trailblazers as a team have only missed one. 11 of 12. And Portland,
with all the calls,
slides on top by one, 65 to 64. Bryant trying to force it inside, turns it over. Valentine gets a piece of it. They push it ahead to Vandeweghe.
And Kiki Vandeweghe's on Bryant.
Tough drive for Vandeweghe.
Great play. Now, Kiki Vandeweghe, realizing that Wallace Bryant was on him, was going to make the drive. But once he gets in there, he finds Sam Perkins. But at least he pulls up enough that he doesn't get the offensive foul.
Portland has Bryant being guarded by Vandeweghe, but Aguirre gets the basketball and scores inside for his 26th of the night and brings Dallas back to a one-point situation, 67-66, Portland on top.
And Aguirre and Vandeweghe tie up elbows as they come across the baseline, and that's a big call against Mark Aguirre as he picks up his fourth foul. You can see him coming along the baseline. Now, there's the contact. He's really trying to pull down on Kiki's arm to receive the ball, and I'm sure Dick Motta is going to have to get Aguirre out of the game.
He's all the offense that they've had tonight.
Now, this Aguirre will see what he thinks.
Bryant gets the rebound for the Dallas Mavericks. He picked up two fouls against Aguirre. Come back with Aguirre. He misses. Perkins follows.
Now, I can't believe Mata is not making a move. Not making a move to get him out of the game. I'm sure they're going to try to get the band away again. It should swing around.
Carnes loses control and gets it back. Wallace Bryant tips it around, but it comes to Drexler. They have a jump ball. Amada's looking at the clock at 6:49. There's going to be a break in the action, so maybe now he'll think about what he's going to do with Mark Aguirre and also think about how the Trailblazers are going to attack him.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
With months of job losses, with family incomes down and the cost of gas, groceries, and healthcare rising, America's credit card debt is now at an all-time high.
If you're currently one of the millions of Americans who's falling behind on payments, debt settlement programs provide options during these most difficult times. This includes the ability to help settle up to 40% or more of your debt.
These consumers took advantage of debt settlement, and just look at the results. Lyons, New York, reduced debt by $24,000. Inglewood, California, reduced debt by $78,000. Call now for free information on all of your options. Options that could reduce your debt by as much as 40% and lower your payment to as little as $167 per month.
Debt settlement representatives are standing by to take your call and help you get your life back on track. This includes the ability to help settle the debt you owe by 40% or more, and the ability to lower your overall payment to only $167 a month. Make that call now.
James, outside James, it's in the clear. James, to the 30, a Michael James, to the 10, 5, touchdown, Oregon lead.
Hey, it's nice to be back in Portland. This is Buck Wheels from the 1990s Great Trailblazer team. I was traded here in 1989. Maurice Lucas recommended to the Trailblazers that I'd be a great fit for the Trailblazers. The fans were the best in the league when I played. They always were into the game. The fans are so important what the Trailblazers do. And it's nice to have those kind of fans cheering for you every game. All the sellout, all the excitement, is just probably the most memorable time of my life. Fans, I just can't wait to get started. We're in for an exciting season, a lot of great basketball teams. Thanks for all the support. I look forward to seeing all of you this year.
Vandeweghe got his black eye in game number 3. So even though Dallas is a small team, they play physical inside. We see Blackman and Brad Davis talking, a combination that is yet to get on track with the Dallas Mavericks, particularly number 22, who came into the ballgame averaging 38. And
but there's one thing about him. He can probably get 20 in one quarter.
He has the ability to go for those kinds of numbers, and Dick Motta is probably saying, and I've sat next to the Dallas bench before when things got going, I need it now. Wrote, I need it now. So we'll see how Blackman responds to the coach's urging.
What?
The Trailblazers fans are up on their feet urging their team.
Well, I told you, I'm surprised that Aguirre's in. Do you agree, Steve?
I am surprised in light of how little offense he's gotten from other areas.
Is
Dallas Mavericks and Wallace try and control the tap, so the Mavericks with that one-point advantage of 6:45 will try to increase it. Perkins just inside the three-point line. Bryant keeps it alive.
Clyde. Clyde on the back of Bryant. That is number, and you're holding out your whole hand, that is number five on Clyde Drexler. And I guess that's one of those plays, Steve, that we were a little remiss in not saying why is Clyde Drexler still in there if he has four. We've talked about this before, but coaches don't seem to be concerned about those fourth fouls in critical situations. When I played, and a lot of teams, it's automatic. It is automatic. If you had four fouls in this, at this stage of a basketball game, as soon as you get to fourth, you might as well be heading for the bench because you're not going to play.
So Bryant is going to get some numbers. He has yet to score until that free throw, so he had no average. He gets them both.
It's going to be below one, his average still.
But he's got some numbers. The Dallas Mavericks have a three-point advantage again, 70-67. Aguirre still has to handle Vandeweghe.
Oh, nice shot by Kiki Vandeweghe. Maybe he should look, can't fault for the jump shot, but he might look for that drive against Aguirre. But Aguirre's giving him the outside shot. If he keeps it in, they'll have to come out on him.
Dallas comes back to Aguirre. And he's clean over a shot by Carr. He has 28. He had 30 in game three. So Aguirre's through to game two, three for him. Paxton.
Paxton's got it going. Paxton had it going in the first half when he came in, hit four out of seven.
And Paxton has had a good shooting series against the Dallas Mavericks. And continues to do so and brings Portland within one. 71-72. Blackman on the offensive charge.
And he's not saying anything about this one. He's just leaning in with that shoulder and left arm. Darnell Valentine playing excellent position. And there's a contact, a shove. Good call.
The moment of truth may be at hand for the Dallas Mavericks right now. Jay Vincent into the ball game along with Blackman, Perkins, Bryant, and Brad Davis. And they have what has been a struggling offensive unit. Valentine. Bryant gets a piece of it from the rear.
And Mata gets away with playing Aguirre with those four personal fouls.
They come to Jay Vincent against Carr. Ball knocked away by Carr.
Tough shot.
Paxton chases his own shot down.
You talk about the first one I said was tough. The second one was impossible, and he gets it to go in.
Paxton jumper off the glass created all of the thunder that you hear. Blackman still cannot get the outside jumper to go down. Blackman will sit down now. Gary Carper replaces him. Portland with a one-point advantage, 73-72.
Well, Mata said, I'm giving up on your jumper.
For the time being.
For the time being, but look out there now.
Bryant from the rear. They call a goal 10 this time. Perkins had Vandeweghe smothered.
Perkins, you're right, was right there. I don't know where this shot would have gone in or not. Perkins goes up, and Bryant comes over and makes sure.
Jay Vincent with the tough drive.
Real tough, because Jay Vincent's not a leaper.
Makes it a one-point advantage for Portland, 75-74. Thompson on the baseline. Mavericks continue to walk it up and slow it down. Perkins inside, squeezes it in.
I tell you, Perkins, he's going to be a player, and the reason is that when he makes that good, strong move.
Wallace Bryant steps around and knocks it away, and the Mavericks will try to run, and they turn it over, and a rare one for Brad Davis.
Well, rare one, I don't know whether it's rare because he hardly makes it or rare because he hardly ever runs a fast break. I don't know which way you mean that.
Rare in the fast break, rare in the fact that he hardly makes the... pick up the foul. That's his third team. The one thing that the Mavericks have not been able to do is really take advantage of the free throw situation. They got in it at 9:08. They're now down to 3:23, and they have not seen a lot of time on the line.
Darnell Valentine thinking about going around Brad Davis, but... Now that was a great move. Thompson saying he didn't have any trouble going around Bryant. Quick step, little pump like he's going to go for the jumper, and then the strong, and I underline strong move to the basket.
Bryant picks up his fourth personal foul, 14. Thompson will step to the line with the chance to give Portland a four-point advantage, which would be their largest of the second half. Mavericks have led on several occasions by three. Dick Motta wants to have a timeout, so we got to break it in action at 3:06. The Trailblazers 80, the Dallas Mavericks 76. And Dick Motta is now trying to find a way to score.
Ain't nothing gonna break my stride. Nobody's gonna slow me down. Oh no, I've gotta keep on moving. Ain't nothing gonna break my stride. I'm running and I won't touch ground. Oh no, I've gotta keep on moving.
$50,000 races are on the line in the Washington Cup this Sunday. Just 3 weeks of live racing left, so come play the ponies. Race times and more at EmeraldDowns.com.
Brotherly love of beer. 1978, home brewing is legalized. 1983, tired of working for the man, the Widmer brothers quit their jobs and cobbled together a brewery. Today, every batch of Widmer remains true to their goal, to brew beer people love as much as they do. Widmer Hefeweizen, the cloudy beer served with a lemon.
This is Ted.
Hey, Pete.
This is his wife, Ann. Ted just turned 50. He now has a much higher risk of getting colon cancer. Ann wants him to visit his doctor to get checked, like she did. She won't get off Ted's back until he does.
Very nice people. We want to make
you
sure
go,
that we
Ann.
Have that 30%.
If you're 50 or older, talk to your doctor about getting tested for colon cancer. For a free information kit, call 800-ACS-2345. This is the American Cancer Society.
Relive the drama. Relive the excitement. Relive the intensity. Relive the moment.
Looking, throwing. God!
Catch an encore presentation of the Ducks football game against Tennessee. Saturday at 11 and Sunday at 6:30 on Comcast Sportsnet.
If you want to get lube by a real Toyota mechanic, get the Broadway Toyota and we'll drain you, plug you, lube you, and rotate your tires for just $49.95 for most cars. For genuine Toyota parts and service without an appointment, Broadway is the only way, and we're right at the top of the I-5 Rose Quarter exit.
What's your 2:30 feeling like?
Well, it's like my brain just stops working.
Feel fuzzy, groggy.
I can barely keep my eyes open.
So what do you do?
I used to get another coffee.
Yeah, coffee or soda.
Then another coffee.
But I switched to 5-Hour Energy.
Just one 5-Hour Energy.
The rest of the day, I'm great.
Zero sugar, only 4 calories.
I don't feel jittery. I'm in control. It's me. Just a better, more awake me.
Gotta try 5-Hour Energy.
5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now. No 2:30 feeling later.
If you could get a new Corolla for just $149 a month, why drive anything but a Toyota? Right now at Broadway Toyota at the Rose Quarter, lease a new 2010 Corolla for just $149 a month. Broadway is the only way, and we're right at the top of the I-5 Rose Quarter exit.
Dallas will now try to answer. They look inside to Jay Vincent. Double. Perkins. Strong drive, but it ends up short. Carr with the better rebound.
Block. Good call. Brad Davis moves right over in front of Jim Paxton as he comes across the 10-second line. Now watch Davis. Now he's just going to move over in front of Jim Paxton. Good call.
actually an outstanding play by Davis, simply because they were going to get beat in the break. In the period, the Trailblazers are shooting 69%, 11 of 16, the Dallas Mavericks 55.
And right there, you're looking at bench strength.
Well, the Trailblazers are 14 of 15 from the line and have a 6-point advantage, 86-76. Picks up his fourth personal foul. So the Trailblazers, even with an advantage, are creating some problems for themselves trying to shut down the inside game. Bowie's on the bench with four. Drexler's on the bench with five. Thompson is playing with four. McGuire for Dallas has four personal fouls. Monty Norris, with encouragement from the crowd, will check in.
You know what the crowd wants out of Audie.
I know that Audie wants to play more than the butcher role.
You're right there.
Perkins looks better with this free throw. He has 15 and brings the Mavericks within four, 82-78. Away against Perkins. That's going to be short. Harper goes down and under Vandeway and has nine, and Dallas falls back to within two, 82-80.
Amada looking up again, trying to decide when he's going to put Blackman and Aguirre back in.
We're down to just the 2 minute mark. Passing hit from long range. He has 16.
That was close to three. The Hawdies are, I tell you, once you have a reputation for fouling, it doesn't make any difference what you do. The contact, as he tries to go around, Sam Perkins, Perkins falls back. Hawdy picks up the foul. Now watch right now, he's going to try to release and go around, and you know, that really isn't a foul, but what happens is he puts a lot of pressure on the guy, his offensive man tries to back in, and then all he releases and tries to go in around him, and that's where he's called for the foul. I think they're going to have to work with Audie and let him know that he's going to have to make some kind of contact to stand the guy up and then try to go around him.
Good point. Perkins gets on the line, but misses the first, cashes the second. 16 for Perkins, 3-point advantage for Portland, 84-81, with a minute 45 remaining in the third period. Vandeway, right outside the three-point line, comes back to Valentine.
Great shot. That's the best defense Brad Davis has played on Valentine, and Valentine gets the hoop.
Valentine pushes Portland's lead to five, 86-81. Seconds on the shot clock. Harper's asking for the ball. Whistle against Carr.
Well, Kenny Carr picking up his fourth personal foul.
Excuse me, three.
Third personal foul, excuse us.
Benson has eight. Shutters go down, and the free throw is true. Fuller working to Paxson, gets Harper off his feet. Long rebound comes to Sam Perkins. So Paxson, who hasn't missed many tonight, misses that runner. And Dallas will try to crawl within one with this possession. Harper. transfers wide open. Benson working inside. Misses Carr, rebound.
Good decision by Kenny Carr.
Great pass from Valentine to North coming down the lane. And that pushes Portland back up by five with 21 seconds remaining in the ball game.
And watch for the three-pointer. They'll shoot it.
The one-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Brad Davis goes all the way and beats Valentine. So Portland has it with 7 seconds remaining. Valentine comes back. Norris has it, but does not get it away. And at the end of three, the Trailblazers hold a three-point advantage, 88-85.
This football season, rent a tailgate party bus from Portland Limousine. 16 or 32 passenger for your group or company, and ride to the Ducks, Beavers, or Seahawks in style. Party on at tailgatepartybus.com.
No matter what kind of camper you are, Next Adventure has the camping gear you need and low prices every day. The backpacker has options when it comes to comfort at Next Adventure. Lightweight tents, sleeping bags, and sleeping pads. Plus, portable chairs, camp stoves, food, and more. The car camper has the ultimate in luxury with products from Next Adventure. The turbo tent, sleeping cots, all kinds of stoves, and everything you need for a plush campsite. Choose your level of comfort at Next Adventure. That's Deacon Bryan's Next Adventure. Two local guys and crew who understand adventure.
Animals enrich our lives, make us smile, and complete our families. And when animals and their people need help, Animal Aid is there. Since 1969, Animal Aid has provided a safe haven for homeless animals and financial aid for urgent veterinary care. Contribute and be a part of the Animal Aid legacy. Donate, volunteer, adopt, foster. You can make a difference. Visit animalaidpdx.org for more information.
Hey, Duck fans, want to win the ultimate VIP experience? Carl's Jr., a longtime supporter of Ducks Athletics, is giving fans two chances to win the ultimate Oregon Ducks experience. The winners of the grand prize receive two game tickets and pregame sideline passes, plus hotel accommodations, Ducks gear, and more. All compliments of Carl's Jr. First, second, and third place prizes include Carl's Jr. gift cards and signed Ducks gear. Log on to GoDucks.com now for your chance to win.
Hey, it's nice to be back in Portland. This is Buck Wheels from the 1990s Great Trailblazer team. I was traded here in 1989. Maurice Lucas recommended to the Trailblazers that I would be a great fit for the Trailblazers. The fans were the best in the league when I played. They always were into the game. The fans are so important in what the Trailblazers do. And it's nice to have those kind of fans cheering for you every game. All the sellout, all the excitement, is just probably the most memorable time of my life. Fans, I just can't wait to get started. We're in for an exciting season, a lot of great basketball teams. Thanks for all the support, and I look forward to seeing all of you this year.
This football season, rent a tailgate party bus from Portland Limousine. 16 or 32 passenger for your group or company, and ride to the Ducks, Beavers, or Seahawks in style. Party on at tailgatepartybus.com.
Dallas comes back with a wire at the top of the period. Vandeweghe goes on the drive.
And you know what Mark McGuire's saying? Where's my front line?
Saying where's the help, but there wasn't any that time, and Dallas is down by five, 90-85. Benson calling for the ball. Steve Coulter wants a jump ball.
Now you notice Vincent, he catches the ball. He could have shot it, but he can't jump. He had a block. So he has to get it inside. He has to get some of that beef on somebody to make his move.
Well, he wants it down low. Quick turnaround. That will not stay. Coulter comes back for the rebound. Portland with the chance to go on top by seven with this possession, and that would be the largest of the night. Vandeweghe, Bowie over the top. Blackman comes up with the loose ball. To Sam Bowie.
Excuse me.
Second team. That may as well be it because
Clyde has five. I'm
right.
Sorry.
He will have to sit at some point in this period. I don't think they're complaining about a foul. They're complaining about Sam Bowie picking up the fifth.
Right. Right. Now the thing is, team foul. Already the Blazers have two.
Well, they were in the penalty at 9:08, and Dallas really didn't get a lot of out of it the last period, but you don't want to stay in that situation. Dallas is a good free-throwing team. Norris down low, bulls his way in. Nice move by Audi. He has four. Portland's lead is five, 92-87.
Audi Norris on the wire.
Eight seconds on the shot clock. They double on Aguirre. Panaway cannot get there for the steal. Harper. Bryant keeps it alive, and Blackman finally finds that jumper, which has been on a temporary vacation. He has 13. The Mavericks within three, 92-89. They double on Vandeweghe. Holter for three. Airs it. Norris cannot save it.
Hey, it looks like he was way out of bounds. Only after he saved it. Let's see if we can see his feet. The shot by Coulter way off. Now watch Audie Norris. Oh, his foot was on the line. You can see it between the official's legs.
See if that one shot is ignited. Blackman, as they work back to him. Paxton knocks it away. Coulter is clean. Oh,
little bit of a gamble. If he would have missed this, look at this. Little showboat time, but it worked.
Harper down the lane.
Now I'm right this time. This one's on Bowie. That is his sixth. Another team foul, and Derek Harper to the line. Okay, Harper makes a move now. You can see right there across the arm. Now, he had his hand wrapped around the other side of the ball, but his arm was laying across the arm of Derek Harper.
That wasn't a shot!
They put Harper on the line. Jack Ramsey's up in arms saying he was still dribbling the ball. He was.
That's his best argument.
Bowie leaves the ball game at 9:23 in the fourth. Mark it down and see if Dallas inside attack comes alive. Thompson comes back in. They get one of two. The four-point advantage for Portland, 94-90. About that once a player gets involved offensively, they start to look at the hoop. He's working against Dave Vincent. Does a good job of drawing the foul. This one will be against Vincent. His third. Sam Perkins in the ballgame. Vincent will have to sit down. Of course, Vincent not happy with his series so far and would like a chance to redeem himself.
Well, he may not get the chance because he has not shot well. So he may not get back in.
Norris gets one of two, and the lead is back to five. 90-95. 9:06 remaining in the ball game.
The man with the ball right. Oh, what a move. What a move. Now, you talk about quick. He makes a spin like he may go back to the middle. Now watch what he's going to do when he comes back to the baseline. Now that ball's on its way as he makes the move. The foul against Audie North, but this thing, it's out of the hand and it's all net.
That may signal the reawakening of McGuire, who now has 31. And he had 24 of the 31 at the half. Vandeweghe. Harper fights the ball away from Steve Coulter. Dallas looks like they want to run, but they'll set up. They double on McGuire. Harper tries to draw the foul.
Thompson
comes up looking. That will be five on Michael Thompson.
Okay, watch this. Coulter gets inside. Pretty good defensive error by Bryant, but there's a foul. That would have been better as a no call. Both the players, Perkins and Michael Thompson, going for the basketball. Michael Thompson, though, getting the foul. As Steve says, that's his fifth. Both players there are going after. Now, Audie Norris with a big rebound here. Watch Coulter take it up the floor. Now, this is a good no call. Both Harper trying to do a little play acting there.
Coulter out of the ball game. Thompson, who appeared to jam his ankle, will come out of the ball game. The Mavericks have been able to stay alive in this ball game by their work on the line.
We mentioned the last time Sam Bowie took a seat that it's difficult to get the fast break going without him in there. The guy that would get it going, if Sam's not in, is Michael Thompson. He is now on the bench. The chance to get out and run is going to be much more difficult because there's another guy by the name of Clyde Drexler that's on the bench.
Ball game is tied at 95. The Dallas Mavericks have made 38 of 43 free throws. They double on Paxton. Harper chases the loose ball down off the rebound, miss. The Mavericks have a chance to swing on top.
Now, there's no question about it. None whatsoever. It's the Dallas Mavericks tempo.
They come to McGuire at the top of the key. Blackman keeps it alive. Valentine makes a great steal. Better pass ahead to Carr.
Great play by Valentine, because Blackman had the ball for 2 points. Valentine knocks it away, gets the assist to Kenny Carr. Remember that play.
All right, I'll write it down. 7:35, Valentine steal. Perkins one-on-one.
Oh, good
offensive foul.
Good play by Kenny Carr. Good defensive position.
Drexler comes back at 7:13 with five personal fouls. Paxton will sit.
Okay, Perkins, for some reason, getting the green light to go one-on-one. Easy call. He tried it on the other side of the court. Was not able to get around Kenny Carr, so he tries it at the top of the key. And Kenny Carr limping out. He's holding, it looks like, that left knee. But as Perkins makes his move, I'm sure they probably hit knee on knee. We're going to get another chance to look at it, but this is a big steal that Darnell Valentine had on Blackman, and then a good pass to Kenny Carr. Kenny's limping, but he's going to stay in the game.
Well, he's going to try to walk it off. We'll see.
So he's going to have to take a few more steps because he's not walking well.
The Mavericks got back in the ball game by virtue of the line. They tied it at 95. Portland, with that steal from Valentine, go back on top with a Carr layup by two. 97-95. Michael Thompson is back behind the bench trying to shake off his ankle injury. So Portland finding himself with some problems. Vandeweghe. Carr with the strong rebound inside.
Strong is the word. That was just a super rebound and a big one. Okay, the shot looks good. They even had a chance to stay in. But Kenny Carr over the top of Sam Perkins.
What's your 2:30 feeling like?
Well, it's like my brain just stops working.
Feel fuzzy, groggy.
I can barely keep my eyes open.
So what do you do?
I used to get another coffee.
Yeah, coffee or soda.
Then another coffee.
But I switched to 5-Hour Energy.
Just one 5-Hour Energy.
The rest of the day, I'm great.
Zero sugar, only 4 calories.
I don't feel jittery. I'm in control. It's me. Just a better, more awake me.
Gotta try 5-Hour Energy.
5-Hour Energy. Hours of energy now. No 2:30 feeling later.
The YMCA's Tee Off for Teens Golf Fundraiser is Thursday, September 23rd at the Reserve Golf Club. Whether you're a business, a golfer, or just a friend of the Y, this is your chance to help. The event will raise money for the Y's Teen Division, whose goal is to provide empowering programs to youth throughout the Portland and Vancouver area. To find out more about the YMCA's Tee Off for Teens, visit ymca-teen.org.
If human achievement can be determined not by speed or strength, but by character, then it's easy to see who the most amazing athletes really are. Be a fan of dignity, acceptance, and the human race. Volunteer, coach, or compete in Special Olympics. Special Olympics. Be a fan.
It's okay to analyze and be critical. Yeah, people get so defensive. What are the Portland Trailblazers? What do they want to be?
You have to calm down. You're not allowed to get excited.
I get it. Listen, I get it. It's not all about you, Bert.
I know it's not about me, but there's a part of me.
You just lit up like a Christmas tree. I am so excited.
The Fan with Isaac and Big Sook. Weekdays at 3 p.m. on Comcast Sportsnet.
With months of job losses, with family incomes down and the cost of gas, groceries, and healthcare rising, America's credit card debt is now at an all-time high.
If you're currently one of the millions of Americans who's falling behind on payments, debt settlement programs provide options during these most difficult times. This includes the ability to help settle up to 40% or more of your debt.
These consumers took advantage of debt settlement, and just look at the results. Lyons, New York, reduced debt by $24,000. Inglewood, California, reduced debt by $78,000. Call now for free information on all of your options. Options that could reduce your debt by as much as 40% and lower your payment to as little as $167 per month.
Debt settlement representatives are standing by to take your call and help you get your life back on track. This includes the ability to help settle the debt you owe by 40% or more, and the ability to lower your overall payment to only $167 a month. Make that call now.
Jerome Kersey is in the ball game replacing Kiki Vandeweghe, and he will join Norris and Carr up front, Drexler and Valentine in the backcourt.
Well, the message to Jerome Kersey should have been, just go out there and play, have fun, go hard at it. And then they can make the decision where he's going to be effective, but he's going to be important.
Eleven seconds on the clock. Valentine.
Oh, that is nice.
So Valentine has 10, and Portland's lead is 4. Biggest lead of the night for Portland has been 6. Nice drive by Harper, but he leaves it short.
And again, the last few times down the court for the Mavericks, they go to Perkins and the Harper.
We talked about the free throw situation not really hurting Portland and the fact that they're not getting anything inside. Kersey comes back with that jumper and makes it a 6-point ball game. Portland scores 4 straight, 101-95. They set Bourgeois. He wants that spot, and they're fighting Norris, and they can't get him the ball. Harper. Ryan keeps it alive, and will get called for the foul. 5 on Wallace Bryant.
Okay, Wallace Bryant's going to reach over the top. You see him holding out Kenny Carr, and the contact really before the ball comes off. And now's the time. This is a stretch drive here, fourth quarter, 5:40 to go.
Norris has 9 rebounds as they come to Jerome Kersey on the baseline. Aguirre rebound. Long outlet to Blackman, who's been quiet tonight. Valentine near steal. Tejada, knowing that this last 5:26 is the most important of their season, calls a timeout with his team struggling and down by 6, 101-95. See what the crowd thinks right here. We take a look at Jerome Kersey.
Well, Kersey in the game, too many fouls in that front line. Now he's doing the right thing. Aguirre not playing him. He has to take that outside jump shot. The next time he goes for the drive, was not quite as effective as it did to pull up for the short jumper.
This crowd wants the Trailblazers to hold on to this lead with a 5:26 remaining in the ball game and get ready for the Los Angeles Lakers. They come to Blackman with 6 seconds left. Tough shot. Chases it down.
Well, Valentine's going to pick up a foul as he tries to keep Rondo Blackman off of the boards. Not too much is being said. Let's see if we can see it. The ball is going to come out long, long rebound. Can't do anything about this. And Darnell reaches across the top trying to knock it away.
Valentine has three. The team has been in a penalty, but it has not hurt them. They got in at 8:21. Blackman has run into one of the ball games we've talked about that comes for offensive players. It just won't go in. And he's having a lousy night of 15.
Well, one thing about an offensive player, usually what has happened for most of the game will not stop in the last few minutes, so I don't think Blackman's going to hesitate to put her up.
101-97, Portland works the car inside. Off the play. There's Jerome Kersey over the top
of everybody. This is Clyde Drexler. Clyde's in there.
Excuse me. Clyde Drexler with that two. And there's pressure on Bryant.
And now they've got him down to 10 seconds, so they accomplished what they wanted to.
They come back to Blackman. They come into Aguirre against Michael Thompson. Good move by Aguirre. He turns the defense around. He has 33, 103-99. 4 minutes, 27 seconds before the buzzer. Thompson beat Bryant to the hoop step, but misses the outside jumper this time. Harper is open. Dallas is playing a lot of catch outside, so they're not taking advantage of any of the size. Perkins inside.
Uh-oh. Well, the mismatch, Harper was on the outside. Valentine had to pick up Perkins. Kenny Carr and Valentine could not make the switch. Good bounce pass into Perkins. And there's a foul called against Jerome Kersey.
Vandeweghe replaces Jerome Kersey. The Mavericks, as I said earlier, have been able to do most of their work right here on the free throw line with staying in the ball game. Perkins, with this completion of the three-point play, could make it a one-point ball game again. 103-102, Portland by one.
If these close games bother you out there and get you a little nervous, you better close one eye, because this one looks like it's going to go down to the last shot.
Drexler gets the spread floor. Tries to create. Catches his own ball.
Yep. That's what they're calling, Steve.
But the one thing that's amazing by Clyde, he seems to know where the ball is. He threw it. He caught it, even though it was an illegal play.
Well, if you throw the ball, you ought to know where it's going to go. But well, you're right. I know what you're saying. He knows.
They're looking for Aguirre. They got it. Thompson turned around.
Oh, my God.
Tremendous play by Aguirre and gets the foul against Kenny Carr, and that's the fourth on Carr.
Okay, there's the play. Now, once a player like Aguirre, we mentioned it earlier, once he's making that turnaround jump shot, the guys start thinking, I got to get up and stop that. And then he goes to the hoop, and that's what great offensive players will do, whether they're down low or whether they're out front.
So it pops out for Aguirre. Portland is down one now, 104 to 103. We are now down to 3 minutes to play. Valentine inside.
Good play by Valentine. The best part of the play was yelling at the end because he was in there where he did not have any place to go, but he realizes that he's going to have to make some kind of emotions, either yelling or get hit as he comes through here, and he's just throwing it up. He's looking for some kind of contact to get a trip to the foul line, and he gets it. Gets the foul on Sam Perkins.
Vandeweghe comes out of the ball game. Norris in. Valentine ties it. And Portland is 16 of 18 from the line, so they've got the ball well from the line. They just haven't been there as many times as the Mavericks.
Sam Perkins has 5 fouls.
Valentine, with the 2 free throws, has 12. And Aguirre comes out to start the offense for Dallas.
Guess who it's going to go into?
Oh, he was trying to draw a foul against Audie Norris on that particular try. Aguirre has 37.
You talk about a call. They have not done that one time in the series. They have not executed that until they need the big hoop. And the play is, and if you've been watching the series, they run that triangle. Aguirre will pin down, meaning set a pick for the guard. The guard will pop out. The guard will receive it and try to drop it down on Aguirre.
This football season, rent a tailgate party bus from Portland Limousine. 16 or 32 passenger for your group or company, and ride to the Ducks, Beavers, or Seahawks in style. Party on at tailgatepartybus.com.
James, outside James, it's in the clear. James, to the 30, for Michael James, to the 10, 5, touchdown, Oregon lead.
That's me, L508-58544P. But I'm not just a number. I have a purpose. A higher purpose.
Have some respect!
Not good. No, man. Hello? No. Finally, the buck stops here.
McDonald's meaty, melty McDouble with 100% beef and cheese. And the juicy McChicken. Just some of the irresistible choices on the dollar menu. Only at McDonald's.
Hey, it's nice to be back in Portland. This is Buck Wheels from the 1990s Great Trailblazer team. I was traded here in 1989. Maurice Lucas recommended to the Trailblazers that I would be a great fit for the Trailblazers. The fans were the best in the league when I played. They always were into the game. The fans are so important what the Trailblazers do. And it's nice to have those kind of fans cheering for you every game. All the sellout, all the excitement, is just probably the most memorable time of my life. Fans, I just can't wait to get started. We're in for an exciting season, a lot of great basketball team. Thanks for all the support, and I look forward to seeing all of you this year.
Of brotherly love, of beer. 1984, brothers Kurt and Rob Widmer turn a homebrewing hobby into a vocation. 1986, the Widmer brothers pioneered the American Hefeweizen. To complement its natural citrus notes, they serve it with a lemon, and a legend is born. Today, it remains the definitive American wheat beer. Widmer Hefeweizen, the cloudy beer served with a lemon.
Hey, Duck football fans. On Monday nights, check out a new weekly show on Comcast Sportsnet, Oregon Football with Chip Kelly, featuring game recaps, insider info, and the most in-depth Oregon football coverage around. Oregon Football with Chip Kelly, Mondays at 8 p.m. on Comcast Sportsnet.
This football season, rent a tailgate party bus from Portland Limousine. 16 or 32 passenger for your group or company, and ride to the Ducks, Beavers, or Seahawks in style. Party on at tailgatepartybus.com.
Portland comes back with the lineup of Drexler, Paxson in the backcourt, Vandeweghe, Carr, and Michael Thompson. to Paxson just at the three-point line. That one will be short. Wallace Byard with the huge rebound for Dallas.
Okay, now, big defensive trip for the Blazers.
McGuire has been the story. Blackman gets the foul. He didn't have any chance of getting it to the hoop,
but he almost made it. Now Pax is upset. Let's see right there. He's upset. All we can see from there is that he's trying to fight through a pick. You don't see where someone's bumped him, so it must have been something that happened right before Paxson trying to go through Aguirre.
Has done all of his work tonight at the line. Gets the bounce and gives Dallas a three-point advantage, 108 to 105.
Now they have been trying to go to keep the band away all the time. I think it's time they're going to have to go to Paxson or Clyde Drexler.
They come to Drexler. He draws a personal foul.
It's like Sam Perkins, I believe, and that will be his sixth foul. And that'll get Jay Vince in the game, but they've been trying to go the Kiki band away. Kiki doing a good job, but they stopped him the last couple of times, so you had to try to get it to one of your other scorers. Paxson can hit the outside jump shot, but Clyde Drexler can make the penetration, the outside jump shot, or find somebody else. And so that was a wise call.
I like this minor now using a little bit more time. He wants to know how much time he has before he has to make this substitution and stealing a little bit more by asking. Now sends Jay Vincent back into the ballgame.
Now Mark Aguirre, during all this, been sitting down at midcourt. Now he's back up on his knees, taking a little rest.
The collective groans here tell you the results of Drexler's free throw attempt. He gets one of two. It's a two-point advantage for the Dallas Mavericks. 108-106. They have Blackman and Bryant out high, and they give the side to Aguirre.
Here it comes. This is a play they work on.
Paxson does a good job of keeping Blackman out of it. Aguirre gets rid of Michael Thompson.
Michael holds his head, but it looked like from the way the ball comes out of Aguirre's hands that he probably had a hold of the arm. Let's see as he goes up. You can see the hand, the left hand of Michael Thompson on the left hand of Mark Aguirre. That's why you can always tell when that ball comes out at a funny angle that he didn't get ball, he got a hand when it pops up like that. When you're going across the top of somebody, you can't go up unless you pull the hand off the ball.
Some more of Larry Steele's tricks have just been revealed. Well, Scott Ellsworth, we're running out of numbers for Mr. Aguirre. We did this for Blackman. Aguirre has 39, and the Mavericks lead by four. 110, 106. A minute 20 remaining in the ballgame. Vandeweghe outside the three-point line. Comes for two.
That is one big shot there. Aguirre playing not bad defense, but Kiki had to work for that one. They're going to run a four. You know who's going to be involved in this. It's going to be Aguirre again.
Aguirre turns it over. We've seen him do that before. He did it against Michael Thompson, and now the Trailblazers with 101 remaining have a chance to tie.
Well, Aguirre not even running back in defense, but he puts it in his way. He tried to blame somebody else, but that was all Mark Aguirre's fault. And they're still looking for Kiki Vandeweghe.
Carr.
Oh, my goodness.
This could be fall the other way.
Now watch Jimmy Carr. Now, both teams have had their complaints tonight about fall. If you're a Dallas Mavericks fan, you're upset with that. If you're a Portland Blazers fan, which I think everybody listening is, says about time we had one go the other way. So
Ball game is tied at 110. He's got a sign to replace you, Jim Paxton. The Dallas Mavericks want to have a conversation. Down by one with 45 seconds remaining in the contest. Portland runs off. Five straight to go on top, 110. 111 to 110.
Yeah, this is a tough play by Kiki Vandeweghe. He's working hard for this. He's got to shake Mark Aguirre. And now he pumps, then goes up, and look at that follow through, and that's nothing but the bottom of the net. Now,
the thing that makes that shot tough for Vandeweghe is he's not a guy that shoots on the move. He likes to turn and get square, so he had to take some additional time.
Well, we said it was going to go to the wire. The team that has the last possession, that executes on the last possession, may win the game. Right now, pretty good play by Kenny Carr as he makes a move, and he's going to go right through Jay Vincent, and as Steve said, and I would agree, could have been against Kenny Carr, but as we also mentioned, maybe it's about time that one was in favor of the Portland Trailblazers. So it's one of those things, as long as they're consistent, and I think the officials have been.
All right. I want to tell you all that I had somebody call me on my talk show today and say, whatever the Trailblazers' margin of victory was at the end of three, that would be their margin of victory in the ball game. So you don't have to worry. The Trailblazers are going to win it by three. The score at the end of three was 88-85. They have a one-point advantage now.
If he gets it right, he better call in on Saturday.
Jay Vincent, who had trouble triggering the ball in down in Dallas, will be the trigger man as they come back with Davis and Blackman. Aguirre. Blackman. Vincent keeps it alive. Valentine.
No. Okay, now. It looked like Valentine had the front of the ball when I saw it. Let's see if he does. Vincent's going to put it down and start to the hoop. Let's see as he comes across. Yep, you're right, Steve. He comes down the arm and then the ball. Now this puts it in an interesting situation. We said the team that executes it the last, if Jay Vincent gets this one, he doesn't. But 37 seconds to go, whatever happens, the Mavericks are going to get another try. This is a big one.
He ties it up, and Jack Ramsey wants a timeout with the ball game tied at 111.
If you want to get lube by a real Toyota mechanic, get the Broadway Toyota and we'll drain you, plug you, lube you, and rotate your tires for just $49.95 for most cars. For genuine Toyota parts and service without an appointment, Broadway is the only way, and we're right at the top of the I-5 Rose Quarter exit.
Why would someone switch to a different auto insurance company?
Me, I wanted to save money, and I did with Amica.
Call 877-52-AMICA now and find out why you should make the change.
I was actually with another company, but I got into this accident with one of Amica's customers, and they were so nice at Amica that I said, that's it. That's what I want.
We hear that a lot.
I switched because I did a bunch of research on who was winning awards for great service and getting the best ratings from consumers, and guess which name kept coming up?
Amica.
Saving money's great, but I got so much more when I called Amica.
Call Amica now and ask about all the different options we have to offer, like accident forgiveness, new car replacement, identity fraud protection, and discounts on getting auto and home insurance together.
More options, more savings. That's why I picked Amica.
And with our driver rewards program, you'll start earning points as soon as you become an Amica customer. Those points can help you save on deductibles and more.
So call Amica.
Hey, Duck fans, want to win the ultimate VIP experience? Carl's Jr., a longtime supporter of Ducks Athletics, is giving fans two chances to win the ultimate Oregon Ducks experience. The winners of the grand prize receive two game tickets and pregame sideline passes, plus hotel accommodations, Ducks gear, and more. All compliments of Carl's Jr. First, second, and third place prizes include Carl's Jr. gift cards and signed Ducks gear. Log on to GoDucks.com now for your chance to win.
Thank you.
for this entire room. But I only had to pay for this much of it.
Empire's 60% off sale is on again, and it's better than ever. Shop at home and save 60% on quality name brand carpet with no interest for 1 year. And we install next day.
You can get a lot more carpet for a whole lot less.
60% off is huge. Call today.
800-588-2300. Empire.
Today.
If you could get a new Corolla for just $149 a month, why drive anything but a Toyota? Right now at Broadway Toyota at the Rose Quarter, lease a new 2010 Corolla for just $149 a month. Broadway is the only way, and we're right at the top of the I-5 Rose Quarter exit.
Circles around. They don't let Vandeweghe come free. Audie Norris goes on his own. Biggest shot of Audie Norris' season.
I tell you, that is not an easy shot. Now, you saw when it skims the front or the backside of the rim, really, as it comes off the glass. You're talking about another fraction, and it'll spoon out. But he gets it up right here. There it hits. Stays on the front side of the rim. Drops through, and you're right. I don't think there's any question it was the biggest shot of Audie Norris' career. That'll give you more playing time if they can win this game.
There's no question that Audie Norris was buried on the Trailblazer bench at midseason, didn't know when he would get off of it, suddenly got a chance to play against the Detroit Pistons, had a little scuffle with Kelly Trepuk, has been playing since then and been playing well for the Trailblazers, and suddenly comes up with the biggest shot of his young career, and this season for him, and Portland has an advantage with 22 seconds left.
Let's give him two credits on that play. First one being that it was for Clyde Drexler or Kiki Vandeweghe. Clyde coming off the double pick, rolling to the middle, Kiki Vandeweghe popping out. The Mavericks defensed it well. Audie Norris, instead of just standing out there going, what did I do next, said, at least it looked that way, I'm just going to go to the hoop. Well, even if he was in doubt, you know what you do when you're in doubt? You put her up.
So the Mavericks come back with Aguirre, Vincent, and Ellis up front, Blackman and Davis in the backcourt. Portland counters with Valentine, Drexler, Audie Norris, Jerome Kirsten, and Kenny Carr. Dallas right away. Brad Davis on the pass off.
Oh, he is hit hard. Now, there's the thing. Now, I want to tell you, Davis still down. He's starting to get up. Jerome Kersey, I believe, as we watch Brad Davis, we'll tell you about this play in a second. No, it's Clyde Drexler. But let's tell you what happened on that play. What do you think? What does everybody in the building think is going to happen in the last 17, 18 seconds?
They're going to hold for one.
They're going to hold it for one. So what do? Brad Davis had the green light to do whatever he wanted. No one was really expecting him to try to go down the middle. So he goes down the middle. And on the pass off, it doesn't make any difference. He's going to make a trip to the foul line. But right here, he makes a good move, gets around tight, but there's not anyone in there. It's too late for everyone to react if he dishes off. It was bad defense. It was more of a real heads-up play by Brad Davis. And what's he shooting?
Well, on the year, he shot 88%. For this series, Brad Davis is shooting 88%.
Timeouts left for Jack Ramsey.
Ramsey has 2 and 15 seconds left on the game clock.
He acted calm enough on that, although it had a little bit of back rim.
Jack Ramsey's telling him if he makes it, timeout. So Portland will take a timeout.
What did we say about last possession?
Well, you know, there's one thing about you. When you're right,
you never let up.
Ball game tied at 113 with 15 seconds left. The Trailblazers can hold for the last shot.
They
is that a good strategy, or do you give yourself a chance to rebound?
Well, when I say last shot, I'm thinking within 4 seconds. I think you take a shot around the four-second mark. You do not want to give the Mavericks any opportunity to get another shot off, so I don't think there's any question at this point in time that you're going to wait for the last shot. Now, both teams are in the penalty. So the pressure, again, in this situation, I think, is really on the defense. The Blazers know that unless something very, very unforeseen happens, such as throwing the ball to the Mavericks on the inbound pass, they're going to have the last opportunity to win the game. And hopefully they'll get that shot up around the 4 or 5 second mark. So the pressure is on the defense. They know that they're going to have the last chance. If they miss, they're going to go into overtime. The defense knows if they foul them, they're going to be in big trouble. Now, they will not foul intentionally. So I think the pressure is on the defense in this situation.
So we're down to this. Game one, double overtime. Game two, just a single overtime. Game three ended in regulation. Their owner, Donald Carter, is here. Saying, fellas, get us to one more overtime.
Well, you knew he had to be from Texas. He's the only guy in the arena that has a cowboy hat on.
So Portland had the option of taking it at midcourt. They decide to take it in the back. Why?
I don't know. Well, they're going to have more opportunity to get it in. But the thing that I can't believe is that the Dallas wasn't up pressuring. They're just going to go for the last shot. It's going to be do or die. Now, they got one of these illegal defenses again. They should pack it in.
North!
Yeah! Can you believe that?
Another look will tell you why.
Defense on him, but this is nothing but net.
How much time is left in this ball game? The clock says 1 second.
You got to remember that, again, the pressure is on the defense. Our director, George Walsh, just said, don't foul. Well, that's the problem. That is the problem right there. You don't foul. So when you know you're not going to foul, the Dallas Mavericks realize that the Blazers aren't going to foul. So what's that mean? It means that these Mavericks are going to get it in. They're going to get a shot. And it takes 1 3-pointer to win. It takes 1 2-pointer to tie. They're going to get a shot. It's going to be whether the shot goes in or not. That's going to be the game.
Everybody on their feet.
Good defense.
We have seen Jay Vincent be the trigger man before.
Well, he's got...
And with 1 second to go down in Dallas, Sam Bowie caught his pass. He seemed very tentative about throwing it in then. Dallas is through now.
Okay.
They used their last 20.
So they're going to try it again. Great defense by the Blazers. Great defense would not allow the Mavericks to get it in.
They spread it out. Aguirre. Ramsey goes down and congratulates Dikmata. In a hard-fought struggle, they all come out at center court. And the guy that they're rubbing on their head, Adi Nora.